All right, I'm going to tell you one more story about desire. Young man walks into a monastery, asks to speak to the wise person that's running the monastery, gets in, and is being questioned why he's there, because the head monk is telling him, he says, look, we get people here towards the end of their life who want to spend their last 5 years or 10 years of their life meditating, getting closer to God. You're a young man, you're about 21 years old. You understand what you're saying is that you want to spend the rest of your life in this monastery? And the young man says, yes, I do. So the old man says, well, this is a very serious choice you're making here. We need to discuss this in more detail. Why don't we go outside? There's a little lake outside and there's a little rowboat. Do you know how to swim? And the young man says, no, I don't know how to swim. He says, fine, do you know how to row a boat? The young man says, yep, I know how to row a boat. He says, good, let's go to the middle of the lake where it's very peaceful and quiet and we can discuss that. So they're sitting in the boat, they get to the middle, put down the oars. The old man is asking the young man some questions about his background, where he's from, what he has experienced so far in life. And right in the middle of one of the answers, without any indication that anything is about to happen, the old man picks up the young man and throws him overboard. Now, since the young man doesn't know how to swim, he, of course, starts to drown. He starts to go under and gets back up in the water and comes up for air and starts to go down again and is struggling frantically, gets back up to get some more air in his lungs. And this goes on for a little while till he starts to lose his strength and he's about to start floating away. And the old man picks him up halfway out of the water, allows him a couple of deep breaths, and as he is finishing his second deep breath, he dumps him again. I'm telling you, they're tough in the East. They're tough. Dumps him right again. He goes through the same process again, and one more time, he's about to go, he lifts him up again, allows him a couple of deep breaths, and dumps him again. Third time, this young man is, of course, getting weaker as you go along. He is using all his physical energy trying to stay afloat. This is it for him. You know, he's about to go, and the old man picks him up and puts him back in the boat. And he says to the young man, let's row to the shore now. And the young man has never rowed this fast in his life. He wants to get away from this crazy old man as fast as he can, of course, you know. So he is rowing with whatever energy he has left. He rows to the shore, jumps out of the boat, and stands back and looks at this old man with, you know, questioning, why on earth would you do this to me? And the old man says, let me explain to you why I did that. I have a question for you. What were you thinking of when you were down in the water? And the young man said, what was I thinking of? What do you mean, what was I thinking of? He says, when you were down under the water, what were you thinking about? And the young man said, what do you mean? I was thinking about getting breath. Don't you understand? I don't know how to swim. I'm drowning. I want to get breath in my head so I can stay alive a few seconds longer. I'm a young man. I'm 21 years old. I want to live. I don't want to die. He says, were you thinking of anything else? Were you thinking of maybe having a good time, playing with your friends? The young man says, no. He says, were you thinking maybe taking a nice ride on a horse and having some fun that way? He says, no, master. All I wanted to do was to breathe. Please, that's all I want. There's nothing else. I had no thoughts of anything except breath. Old man looked at him. He says, ah. Good. He says, when you feel the same way about becoming enlightened and studying here in this monastery, as you did about breath a little while ago, you can come back here anytime. Stay here. He says, why don't you meditate on this for a while and see me and let me know what you wish to do. About 30 minutes later, young man walks back in. He says, thank you very much, master. Maybe I'll see you in 40 years. That's not what he wanted, obviously. He was just trying to run away from his problems temporarily, hoping they would go away, you know, for a while. He didn't really want to spend the rest of his life there. He did not have a strong desire to do that at all. There was no desire there. It was maybe a mere wish, or maybe an escape valve, not a desire. So, the first thing you want to do about the things that you say that you want is check out your desire factor. Do you really want this? Or are you maybe saying you want it? Is it maybe old programming? Did somebody else tell you this should be good for you or would be good for you? Check, is this your desire? If it is, fine. Then you're done with that particular element. Yes, I really want to do this or have this or become this or change this or whatever it is you're working on. Second factor is believe. What is your belief system in this area? Do you believe that you can? If you're weak on belief, you might want to do things such as, has anybody else ever done this? In other words, somebody might say, I want to write a book. Has anyone else ever written a book? Yes? Oh yes, hundreds of thousands of people. Well, if it is possible for the other hundreds of thousands of people, maybe it's possible for you. Okay?